Apple, Wikipedia, Google. If you've used any of these companies, then you have felt the golden touch of Guy Kawasaki. He is a Silicon Valley legend, an investor, an evangelist, and now backing an Australian design startup called Canva. But it all began in those early days of Apple.
The stories of Steve Jobs are legendary.
Yes.
Separate some fact from fiction for me. What was he actually like?
Oh, all the stories you've read are true.
Okay, right. Terrifying.
Man. Well, but, you know, it's terrifying. He was a very difficult person to work for. Don't get me wrong. He was a scary person to work for. He would not hesitate to call you a bozo in front of, or worse, in front of all your colleagues.
I was
going
to say, getting called bozo is the thing that happens daily to me.
But he had such vision and such passion, and he was right so often. And if you think about it, you know, Apple created the Apple I, the Apple II, Macintosh, iPod, iPhone, iPad. Most people are lucky to create one revolution, right? You'd be astoundingly lucky to create one revolution. This guy created, you know, five or six. So after about the second or third time, you start believing it's not luck.
Yeah, right.
You know?
No.
Comes at some cost working for him, but I would not trade, and I don't know any Apple employee who would say, God, I regret working for Apple.
So put me in a meeting where he's being a perfectionist. What does that conversation go like?
And you're the cause of the imperfection?
Let's go with that, because I think that might be the most dramatic way of doing this.
So, can we swear on this network?
Yes, we can.
Okay, so he would basically say, this is shit. And then he would say, like, how did you ever get a job with us? And then he would look around the room and he'd say, who hired him? Like, I want to know who hired him. What clueless person hired him? And then we'd go downhill from there. Steve Jobs was proof that fear is a very positive motivating force.
Some people lie.
The culture of what drove Silicon Valley in those early days was driven by sort of a hippie mentality.
Yeah, you know, part of it is the journalistic desire to make it interesting, right? So, you know, so Steve Jobs goes to India, and I don't know what he was doing, like, you know, practicing yoga or whatever he was doing, staring at his navel and all that. And then, you know, like in the Macintosh division, were there illegal substances? Yes. But a lot of that is, you know, you could have a like mediocre CEO who does a lot of yoga and smokes a lot of dope and still have a mediocre CEO. I mean, you know, I mean, this doesn't necessarily cause. If you have a crappy CEO, give him some marijuana and tell him to take yoga, you're still gonna have, you're just gonna have a stoned crappy CEO. Yeah.
But a really flexible one, though.
Yeah, a really flexible
one. Strong core.
Right, right. Downward facing dog. Get ready for, you know, a loss of revenue.
What would you say the biggest mistakes that Steve and Apple made?
I don't think we've seen the biggest failure of Apple.
Is the next big failure Apple Watch?
To be determined. I think there are 5 million people who buy anything Apple makes. So 5 million watches will be sold, let's just say. And then there's gonna be some Johnny Ive video where he says, well, we looked at how time works and we're gonna revolutionize time.
We've developed an entirely new way for you to connect intimately with others.
And we see time as just an extension of your totality of your being.
At an intimate level, to both embrace individuality and inspire desire.
And we use special gold that Tibetan monks mined from the hills of the Himalayas, right? And then chanting monks pounded out these cases one by one. Could I foresee a time where the Apple Watch replaces the car key? Would I like to be able to, you know, check into United Airlines by just scan my watch? Hallelujah. So, you know, there's a rational side of me that says, got too much trouble, you gotta keep one more thing charged. You know, do you wanna like fall into the Apple vortex of resisting Apple's futile? But there are things that if those things came true, and most of them are already true, would I buy the watch? Yes.
As a professional evangelist for technology companies, somebody who is in the business of making people understand what you're trying to do as a company, I would love your point of view on what went wrong with Jay-Z's service Tidal, because they had all the money in the world, all the stars in the world, and they've had nothing but bad publicity. They've dropped out of, I think they've dropped down to the 400th most downloaded app.
Yeah, well,
what did they do wrong?
Well, okay, so all the money in the world is not necessarily a good thing. Right, so all the money in the world means what? You do your, you know, announcement at Carnegie Hall or whatever, and you have this like bottles of Cristal and shrimp and all that, and then you get Madonna and you get, I don't know, I'm like so out of it.
I love you went Madonna.
That's literally the only person I can remember from that thing.
She's the one that dry humped the table.
Yeah, okay, right. But you know, the difficult thing to grok here is this is supposed to be a democratization of music play, right? Mm. And you have billionaires on stage saying, you know, we believe in democracy and equality, and you know, we're trying to support you, the struggling songwriter and performer. It's hard to put those two things together. I'm into democracies. Apple democratized computing. Wikipedia democratizes knowledge. And Canva democratizes design. What I want to do is lower the barriers and make it a meritocracy so that truly the best can achieve domination. How's that?
It's good. It's got a slight touch of the world domination to it. I like it. You're an absolute pleasure to talk to you. Thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.
My pleasure.